This is an interesting little corner of the house.
Around every corner of Michelle Tafoya's Edina home are mementos any sports fan would envy, like this picture of her interviewing Brett Favre after he beat the Packers at the Metrodome, one of her favorite moments in her 10 years as an award-winning sideline reporter for Sunday Night Football.
You look at the sea of cameras around this. I don't think I've ever seen anything like it, even at a Super Bowl where I've done a post-game interview. I mean, that was a moment.
Tafoya's had so many of these moments in her career, her storage room is bursting with them.
That's my Super Bowl, like, credentials and notebooks and stuff.
This was Al Michaels' birthday at the Bellagio. We were doing a game in Las Vegas. And this was Nagano. That was my first Olympic Games.
Super Bowl 56 is the last credential she'll add to this pile. Last Sunday, after one last post-game interview.
Obviously emotional.
Tafoya walked off the field for good.
Michelle Tafoya retiring from sportscasting. Michelle, we love you.
You had one of the most coveted jobs in broadcast. Why would you walk away?
Life is short, and I want to do something that matters. I love this country. I am so devoted to its exceptionalism and well-being in the future for our kids. And I have to do other things. I can't not do other things.
With talk like that, you might think she's running for office.
Well, I'll tell you, Al Michaels has also said, Michelle, if you run for office, I will be your campaign manager.
Are you running for office?
Not immediately. I've been asked to run for office, and I've considered it. This timing wasn't right.
Instead, she announced she will co-chair Republican Kendall Quall's campaign for governor. A move that generated headlines, much like her appearance on The View.
I just want to give the benefit of the doubt.
Where Tafoya shared her opinions on vaccine mandates, she's against them, and former NFL quarterback Colin Kaepernick.
If they believe he could win them a Super Bowl, he would be on a team right now. I promise you that. I promise you that.
Shortly after that appearance, Tafoya was not on the NFL sidelines for three games in a row, sparking rumors she'd been suspended.
Some guy goes, why is Tafoya taking 3 weeks off? Was it her appearance on The View? Didn't call me, didn't ask, asked NBC. They said no. None of this has anything to do with The View or NBC's decision make, none of it, and I promise you that.
Do you regret going on The View?
Not at all, and I'll probably go back if they invite me. If someone invites me to give my opinion and say the things that I believe in, I'm not gonna turn anyone down. And I'm not afraid of the conflict.
So you'll likely see Tafoya in all kinds of new places, from podcasts to cable, talking about anything but football. In fact, she doesn't even think she'll watch it much anymore.
That's my husband when he coached Little League and all the kids signed it.
Instead, she'll be on the sidelines of her son's baseball games and her daughter's soccer matches.
I have missed so many games. I never get those back. And that's a little bit painful to say. But I'm here right now, and I'm going to look forward. I want to help in some way. And I've got some plans, and I'm still thinking about what exactly that's going to be. But I can't be on the sidelines. I can't be on the sidelines anymore.
You know, and she said whatever she does next, obviously she's getting into politics. Mm-hmm. She might start a podcast. She said people say you had such a huge audience and you're going to start with nothing. And she's like, I'm not afraid to work hard. Right. And I've started small before.
So that's true.
Interesting to watch.